out here of the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. Make some noise right now. So, just so you know how we do it, guys, the part of me being the best moderator ever is a part of knowing the fact that I am you guys. I am just as big of a fan of Mighty Morphin Power Rangers as you guys are. So being with that said, this is how we do things. I probably have about 3 questions overall, and I want to make time for everybody in the audience who has a question to be able to ask their question. Sound good? So, here are rules. I got a couple rules. Number one, if you have a question for the Rangers, do me a favor and ask that particular Ranger nothing that everybody has to answer so we can get to as many people as possible. Sound cool? Also, we're going to ask them to morph at the end, so don't do it in the middle. Third thing, if you have a question, don't make it a 2-part question so we can get to as many people as possible. Cool? All right. Beyond that, when we come to you guys, this is a family. As we know, Power Rangers has changed a lot of our lives. This is a family. So when somebody comes up to the microphone and has a question, I want you guys to say your name, say where you're from. When they say where we're from, everybody scream for them. Cool? We're going to try. Let's do it one time to see if y'all get what I'm saying. Ladies and gentlemen, hey, my name is Clayton and I'm from Detroit. I like that. Cool. Come to the stage right now. I want to get this thing started. I don't want to waste any more time. First of all, I want to start with a few of our producers. First of all, Danny Wayne. I want to give it up for Scott Page Packer. Make some noise. Here he is, one of the producers of Power Rangers. Y'all keep it going, boys. Yellow Rangers of all. First of all, you're ruining every time. Ladies and gentlemen, my very good friend, the amazing Red Ranger, the incredible Zeo Blue Ranger, Steve Cardenas. One of my favorite Yellow Rangers of all time. Ladies and gentlemen, start clapping your hands right now. Give it up for Karen Ashley.
Thank you.
questions started lining up. I think the microphone is over there. Get your line, get your questions. Remember the rules? No two-parters, no questions. Everybody has to answer. And make sure, you know what? This is a time that is incredible for Power Rangers fans because we don't have to share Power Rangers with every other convention like we have before. I want you guys to know something. All of these people have booths. They are selling their merchandise and they're meeting you guys. You can do me a favor because they can't say it, so I'm going to say it. When you come to that booth, if you ain't buying nothing, say what's up.
Yeah.
Come give the hello. It's always great to talk to you. But make sure you support them by buying them their prints and other items they have. Can we get a clap on that?
Hugs are free.
Hugs are free. But the prints are not. All right, I'll take it back. I want to start by remembering the rules. How you doing, man? What's your name? Where you from?
I'm Patrick Freak Jr. from Nashville, Tennessee.
What's your question, buddy? What's it for?
Walter, I heard that Doomsday Part 2 was supposed to be like the final finale. What was going through your mind at that point?
Doomsday Part 2, final finale, it was going through my mind.
It sounds like, oh God, it's Doomsday.
That was the finale for the second season.
The one that said, Rita's defeated. You guys don't have to be Rangers anymore. And you guys said, no, we're staying on.
We're staying on, yeah. And you know what? Anytime they tell us that it's time to quit, we say, no. We didn't stop. Man, we're still here. We're here to stay. We're going to make it happen. So I'm sure as Zach, that's what I was thinking. No, we ain't going out like that, Zoran. Let's go.
How do you say no, we good on being Power Rangers after this? Like you saved the world, you got secret identity. I'm about to get it up and go back to math class. What's up, buddy? What's your name? What's your question?
Hey, I'm JR from North Carolina.
North
kind.
I think one of the most consistent things about Power Rangers is that I'm really proud of is the fact that you stand for something positive. You stand for something that inspires young people to want to do more. And that's the one thing about Power Rangers I love. So like, you guys saw the dark version of the Power Rangers right there, right? And you guys see that? That was, it was dark. It was like, it was good. It was interesting. But it wasn't Power Rangers. It wasn't what you guys grew up with. It wasn't inspiration. And I think that's the one thing that's been consistent about the series. In 25 years, we have encouraged young people to be the best they can be. And you guys are great examples of that. And I'm happy about that. It makes me happy.
Thank you. None of this would be possible without you guys on the other side of the table. So honestly, for everyone on this side of the table, a huge shout out to all of you guys for being here to join us
and bring it back. I mean, you know what? I enjoy the YouTube version of Power Rangers, except the fact that they had Zach doing cocaine. I'm like, come on! That's not Zach at all.
That was so edgy.
It was so edgy. I'm like, anyway, first, I have a question before we move on to you with the amazing Rear Ranger shirt. David Phillips, man, first of all, you are everybody in this room, daddy. I don't know if you know that.
Yeah, thanks. It's no pressure.
You are the father.
Man, how did you feel? I always heard you tell the story that when you came in to do Zordon, it was the facial acting that day, and you went on to do voiceover. How was that process, not knowing what this was going to become, and then it blew up? How was that?
Well, I mean, it was bittersweet. Because they ended up only filming the character one time and then recycling it over and over. I remember getting the phone call saying, congratulations, the show's been picked up, the series has been picked up, and I'm like, great, when do I show up to set? And they're like, oh, well, you just need your voice for now. So I feel like I missed out not being able to be on set and to get to know the characters and the actors as much, but coming back after 22 years, and then these guys welcoming with open arms was just fantastic. So, yeah. Welcome.
Scott. My name is Scott, producer of the Power Rangers. Let me ask you this, Scott. When you came, first of all, how many seasons were you on as far as producer standpoint?
In 10 seasons, I started to put the producer credit on the second director. I was directing the voices from the beginning.
So, what for you was one of your favorite moments, being a part of the show for 10 seasons, which is more than a lot of us can even say as fans. What was your favorite moment?
My favorite moments are always working with these knuckleheads in the studio. The studio with us is always a sanctuary for people. You gotta get away from the madness on the set and just play around and be silly. That's one of the things I was gonna say that's consistent from all the shoot. Every season was up me or someone like me at each all these fans like, probably not some of the seasons we had people saying their own names and like when she was flying.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I had Sean Johnson and stuff, so we do a certain girl fun stuff in there. But it's mostly fun being in the studio. I remember Rico Pulso. The guy that voiced for him was a great friend of ours, and he would laugh so hard, and every point was really mean here, but we'll just crack up and laugh again. It was awesome. So it was pretty fun. Plus, yeah, so my fun was always being in the studio. I love it.
We have our hands through hours and hours of yeah. And we have to thank you. Thank you
for
that.
For sure. They had to give me an acting coach. Remember, Paul Schreier was my acting coach for a long time.
both of my because he was like a bully on camera, then off camera he's like, okay,
say it like that. Make sure you make the face go like this.
Yeah.
So when I first got on the show, I had like no acting at all. So to try to act as goofy as I had to act in that episode was like really out of my comfort zone. And every time I still go back and watch that episode, I'm like, I cringe a lot. It's like so bad.
You did well.
Huh? Oh, thank you.
Thank you. That's a good question.
I was like, it wasn't until I started doing Zio where I actually felt a little bit more comfortable with my skin and in front of the camera that way.
Remember when you were a plant?
Yes.
I remember when I was a plant, yeah.
That's the word I remember. Like
twigs sticking out of my ears and my skin was all green.
Yeah, that was pretty funny.
Yeah,
that's
nice thing, too.
Thank you so much, man. He said you guys are all awesome.
Thank you, thank you.
Hey, everybody, how you doing? What's your name? What's your question?
Pretty good.
My name's Arturo, and my hometown is I'm an Army brat, because my dad's in the Army, so I live around many places.
Give it up for Army!
Yeah. Well, my question is for Steve. I want to know, what was it like, or what were you thinking when they were getting, when you were doing, you were no longer going to get the Red Ranger, going to get the Blue Ranger?
Well, I mean, quite honestly, I was happy that, you know, we still had a job, you know? Didn't bring anybody new in, and I'm like, all right, just keep the party going, I'm fine with that. I already knew, you know, that the Red Ranger in the Japanese footage of O-Ranger was the leader, so, you know, there was no question that Tommy was going to become the Red Ranger, so I was, you know, it was just part of what it was, and, you know, I didn't think one way or another about it, to be honest, but I just loved that they changed the set, you know, they made the command center look a lot better. So I was kind of excited about that. Excited for a new uniform, you know, that wasn't shared by anybody else, which is kind of cool. Well, because, you know, I don't know if you guys know or not, but the wardrobe people, they just gave me Austin's old suit. And instead of
holding
it to
fit me,
they made a muscle suit for me to wear underneath it.
I
know. I have a muscle suit. So anytime you see me on the show, like, I'm going to, you know, like, huge.
Yeah.
The budget's good.
Make up a muscle suit instead of like fitting him into the one that you know.
We literally stepped into their shoes. Literally.
Yeah, it was great. You rock.
No, yeah, I like the blue a lot for sure. Yeah, I think it was my favorite season of Orlando.
From somewhere in California. Now I'm gonna just say something about superheroes, okay? There's a lot of superheroes nowadays, but I just want to say you guys were my first superheroes that ever came in my life. And I think a lot of other people in here as well, too. And I had a question. We got four Rangers in here. My question is, if you could team up with any superhero, who would it be?
Who's got specific question for us?
Superman for me.
Black Panther!
Karen, allow me to ask you this.
guys will come up like, oh my God, you're the best. And I can see that person is still really
cool. That's great. Every weekend that happens, like ladies and gentlemen, that's what you call you bring a lot of episodes. Oh, I love them. I love them all. The checks all cash the same. How you doing, buddy? What's your name? What's your pleasure? Hi, CJ from Charlotte, North Carolina. And my question is for a couple of the Power Rangers and Al, the writer. Absolutely not. Which one of your questions for one of the Rangers, then, buddy? Well, there's a couple of responses to this, which is, how do you feel your character represented your demographic on the show? Right, I love that. So who would you like specifically to answer this? That? Cool.
You know what? It's funny because I'm from Detroit, Michigan. Hey. Detroit's a predominantly black city. And so when I got to California and I went to college, started studying musical theater in school. I was aware of it. I was still a minority man. I was like, wow, there's nobody like me here. This is crazy. And so when I got on the Power Rangers and I booked the show and I was going to be a superhero, and then I also was wearing a black costume, I was like, damn, I'm truly a representative I'm in the Power Ranger here. Like, so I felt really inspired because as far as I know, I'm the first black superhero on live action TV.
My question is for Cameron. On the show, while I know and realize you were a dancer, phenomenal dancer, by the way. Our audition, I watched our audition.
Right next to the cool record, am I right? Raise your hand, kid. You are our final question. I want to make sure that I speak to everybody. I want to make sure we get you guys a question in. Blue, it's up to you. What's your name? Where you from, baby?
My name is Dwayne. I'm from Maryland.
Maryland!
I'm like, hey, shut up. And I'm like, you always
pretty sure on this panel you wore the most outfits, I think.
No, me.
Were you? Oh, yeah, because you wore circles, right.
Cowboy girls.
All right, sorry, I'm not thinking Catherine then. You've been jumping in, so if you want to jump in, you can. Out of all the uniforms that you wore, if you were, you're already coming back, if you came back another time, what uniform would you wear? And that includes the jet, actually.
Does it have to be pink?
Thank you.
you just can't tell kids no. So with that, I'm gonna do this for you, Chris. We got Steve's answer, now I'm going to Daniel. Go ahead, man, give me your answer.
All right, I would have to say, oh God, all 10 years, so I can get disqualified.
Thank you.
Okay. Hey, how you doing, my friend? What's your question?
Hi, I'm Vanessa. I'm from Toronto.
Thank you so much for coming. Thank you.